be seated for the scripture reading.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have only all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness, to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but then without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take the offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited. When they ran out of wine, since the wine provided for the wedding was finished, the mother of Jesus said, "They have no wine." But Jesus said, "Woman, why turn to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." There were 6 stone water jars standing there meant for the ablutions that are customary among Jewish people. Each could hold 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." They filled them to the brim. "Draw some out," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this. The steward tasted the water and it turned into wine, having no idea where it came from. Only the servants who had brought the water knew. The steward called the bridegroom and said, "People generally serve the best wine first. They keep a cheaper sort until the guests have had plenty to drink. But you have kept the best wine in now." This was the first of the signs given by Jesus. It was given at Cana in Galilee. Let his glory be seen, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, hi there. Finally made it, huh? Yeah. Well, I gave you a little extra time to think about this. So, Dave, I'm going to ask you again, do you really want to do this? You're sure? Well, he can't say, I asked him twice back there already, Peggy. What do you mean, stop asking? You want to be sure, don't you? You notice I didn't ask Peggy if she wanted to marry him. I mean, that's pretty obvious. Good grief. You both seem pretty happy about this. Yeah. Well, we tried everything we could to dissuade you, but it didn't work. Yeah, sorry about that. Hey, thank you for your patience. And you got to meet everybody already, okay? All right. You heard in the gospel about the wine and the water. I won't be at the reception, so you better not run out. There's nothing I can do about it. The second reading you picked from St. Paul. Amazing reading. A lot of people have the idea that St. Paul doesn't have much to say about marriage, and yet he has so much to say that is so very, very wonderful. If you follow the words that you yourselves selected, they will stand you in great stead. Love is not something that anyone can define. Nobody can define it. But when you look at people who have been married many years, you know what love truly is. The love you have right now, hopefully it's nothing compared to the love that God has in store for both of you in the future. As you come to live your marriage vows together and the commitment you make, then you'll truly come to understand what love is really all about. It's a gift. It's a wonderful, wonderful gift that God gives to his people. And he gives us marriage, especially the sacrament of marriage, to help us to prepare for the one great gift that he has in store for all of us, life in the kingdom. I know you're both young and you think, hey, we're going to be around forever. No, you're not. Eventually, you're going to get old like me. Then eventually, there's no place else to go. And that's when love really kicks in. Because then you begin to understand fully that the reason God brought the two of you together was to prepare you for the ultimate love in his kingdom. In the meantime, the love that you have, it's only a foreshadowing of the great love that he has for both of you. And as you live your life together, if you listen to those words of Paul, love is patient. Well, you've already displayed that today, so you're in good shape there. Neither one of you panicked. In fact, you were outside. I'm not telling you missing out. There was a doggy roast. It's patient. It's kind. It's not jealous. It looks for all the good things in people, not the nitpicking things. And there will be times when, well, your love will be tested. But if you really care for each other, and if you look at that other wonderful gift that God gives you, He gives it to you today, His Son, Jesus. When you were baptized, Jesus said, I will be with you. I will be with you. As you take each other today as man and wife, Jesus promises you once more, I will be with you throughout your married life. And I think after the last year you've gone through with RCIA, you begin to understand what that really means. And if you make Jesus a real partner in your marriage, He promises you the greatest amount of happiness and peace that He can give to anyone. I'm sorry, He doesn't promise that you'll never be sick. He doesn't promise that you'll always have a fantastic job. He promises only one thing. I will be with you. And that's not a bad deal. Throughout your married life, to know that Jesus, God Himself, is with you and with your family. Hold on to it. Make Him a real part of your marriage together. Have a wonderful marriage together. Dave, you still want to do this? You sure? By the way, I will ask you one more time officially.
You're not going to press it, are you? Dave, Peg, you have come together to the Church of St. Leo that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the Church's minister in this community of your family and your friends. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you both in baptism, and now He will enrich and strengthen you by a special sacrament, that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and in lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of this community, I ask you to state your intentions. Not yet.
Not yet.
Dave, Peg, have you come here freely, without reservation, to give yourselves entirely to each other in the sacrament of marriage?
Yes. Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife all the days of your life? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the teaching of Christ and His Church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter the sacrament of marriage, join your right hands, declare your consent before God and His people. Peg, do you take Dave for your lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part?
Me too.
David, do you take Peg for your lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part?
Yeah.
You have declared your consent before God's people. May God keep you both together. What God has joined, no one may ever divide. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as your sign of love and fidelity.
I got you. Enough of them. Pick one, Dave. Place it on Peg's ring finger.
Peg, take this ring.
Peg, you take this ring as a
sign of... As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Sounds like a corkscrew.
David, take this ring.
David, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and
in the
Son,
name of the
Holy
Father,
Spirit.
And of the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Isn't it wonderful? Blow out the two little tapers and blow out the small candles when you're done. Step out.
I lost you, Lord. I lost you, Lord. With words of Let us now ask God to listen to us, to bless our words of prayer, which we offer for the people of all the world.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For leaders of church and state, for heads of institutions, for heads of homes and households, that they will lead us and guide us in the search for God and the good life, in the search for peace and joy, in the search for love among us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married people, for those who married yesterday, for the new couple, Dave and Peggy, married today, for those who will marry tomorrow, that they may savor the joy of being together, warm love and children, a long life, wine and friends, and a new day every day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all young single people who look forward to a vocation full of life and full of love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the lonely old and the lonely young, for the hungry rich and the hungry poor, for the sick in mind, body, and spirit, for the weakness in all of us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our relatives and friends who walk with us on life's journey, and for those who have gone before us to the other side of life, for the fulfillment of all their unfulfilled desires, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
These are our words of prayer today for ourselves and all God's people. Tomorrow there will be others. Lord God, the beloved of humankind, who first loved us, give our words by your listening the power of your word, that all things may be accomplished sweetly and gently for the happiness of all, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You kindly be seated as the offertory gifts are presented. Love is our origin, love our constant calling, love is our fulfillment of heaven. The love of man and woman is made holy in the sacrament of marriage and becomes the mirror of your everlasting love. Through Christ, the choirs of angels and all the saints praise and worship your glory. May our voices blend with theirs as we join in their unending hymn of praise. When supper was ended, he took the cup, and again he gave thanks and praise. Gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this, remember me." Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Source of blessing for married life. they may together rejoice in your gift of married love. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy. May they turn to you in their sorrow. May they be glad that you help them when they are in need. May they pray to you in the community of the church, and may they be your witnesses in our world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Jesus the Lord. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant us the peace, the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be always with you. We offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. By the way, you better say nice things to them at the reception. And we have a beautiful church upstairs. Beautiful place. And it's also very, very hot. Even on a wonderful day like this, it would be about 85 up there. It's about 70 in here. Thank you. Let us pray. Lord, in your love, you have given us the Eucharist to unite us with one another and with you. As you have made David and Peggy one in the sacrament of marriage and in the sharing of the one bread and the one cup, so now make them one in their love for each other. We ask this through Jesus the Lord. And the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings upon this bridegroom and his bride. May the Lord Jesus, who was a guest at the wedding of Cana in Galilee, bless you, your family, and your friends. May Jesus, who loved his church to the end, always fill your hearts with his love. May he grant that as you live in this sacrament, so may you wait for him in joy and in hope. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go and live the joy and the peace that is Christ.
Hi.
And a kiss. Thank you.
Brookside Manors, Somerton Room. My name is Bob, I'm your MC. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to focus your attention on to the door all the way at the back as we introduce to you the members of the bridal party. Ladies and gentlemen, seated and coming in first, please welcome our bride's grandmother, Janet Power, escorted by her son, William Power Jr.
Broken old street light, lock the door.
special favor for all of our guests and their significant others to join them on the floor for their first dance.
You will be missed at our home, and I know you'll come back frequently, but it won't be the same without you. But I know you're going to a great place, so I'm very happy for you. I know you'll be happy with Peggy. And also, I want to thank you for all the great memories throughout the years. I'll never forget sledding in the park, going to the movies, playing video games, which, by the way, I'm still hooked on. And that's what we do to you. And I know there'll be many more great memories in the future, so I look forward to them as well. And also, I just want everyone to know that these past couple months and the past year have definitely been the happiest I've ever seen my brother throughout the 31 years. And I know it's all because of Peggy. And this wasn't written today, but even today at the seeing him dance and at the church was definitely the biggest smile I ever saw on him. So I know he's a very lucky guy, and he's obviously very happy. That makes me happy to see how happy you are, Dave. So, and Dad, just want you to know, you're just like I said before, you're a lucky guy. Peggy's a great girl, and if I meet someone as nice as her, I will consider myself to be a very lucky person. And finally, Peggy, I just want to wish you into our family, and I'm just so happy you're part of our family, and thank you very much.
That's okay, he forgot his place. That's okay, you can sit down for the next toast, because we're going to call up Kim, who's going to give our next toast up here at the microphone.
Well, I didn't want to make a speech that, you know, I wrote down beforehand. I wanted to just speak to Dave and Peggy. I've only known you for a short time, a few years, but it's felt like a whole lifetime. Peggy, you're a sister I never had, and I love you dearly. I'm so honored that you asked me to be your maid of honor, and I'm so happy to do it. Dave, you're one of the nicest men I've ever met, and I'm just proud to be called your friends. So congratulations, and good luck with everything, and I hope you have plenty of bubbas of your own. And Steve, Peggy's father, if he would come up to say the next speech, that would be great. Thank you.
I wanted to congratulate you on your wedding. And my blessing to you is, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, remain in your hearts throughout your married lives. God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
David and Peggy, I wish you a lifetime of happiness. You're very nice, both of you couple, and I couldn't be happier today for the both of you. Okay, bye.
Well, your mother stole the thunder from me. I'll say about the same thing. Best of luck.
Okay, David, this is a lifetime of bills starting for you. You're going to be in debt for the rest of your life. Believe me, marriage is a wonderful thing. Financially, it's the pits. Take care, Dave. I wish you the very, very best. You and your bride, Peggy. Thank you.
I want to wish Peggy and Dave the best of luck. May all their problems be little ones and have a happy life and an enjoyable life. And you look like a great couple. And I hope it plays out for you. It played out for the rest of us, so I'm sure it's going to play out for you. Okay.
Congratulations. Wish you the best in life. And don't take yourself too seriously. Have a good time. Take care. David. Uncle Paul.
David and Peggy, congratulations. And have a great life together. Thank you.
This is Aunt Rita speaking. Have a good married life. Wish you the very best. Lots of bambinos. Stay well. Bye-bye.
Hiya, Peggy and Dave. Congratulations. All the happiness in the world forever and ever. Take care.
Peggy, Dave, have a great life together, and I hope that you have many, many children. And don't forget to come see us sometime. We love you. God bless. Thank you.
I'd like to say a few words to the bride and groom. I wish them a very successful married life, and I'll see you again on your 25th wedding anniversary. God bless you, and I hope you have a long, successful life. God bless you.
See what you're eyes. Okay. Peggy, David, this fellow's asking me to say a few words. Well, first of all, I wish you many years of happiness, okay? And a whole hell of a lot of kids. Bad kids. Okay? That's the first thing, but I know you'll be able to handle it. And thanks for getting married. Your mom's off the hook now. I know she feels a lot better. But we hope you all the best. That's true. We, the whole family here and everything, we wish you the best. And I know you'll have a good time at this. Take care.
Peggy, Peggy's his grandma. I love you. And I'm happy to be your grandmother. And I know Uncle Billy's happy to be your godfather. I love you, and many happy returns for you and David, and God bless you both. I love you both.
Now, Peggy, David, I hope you have many happy years together. I also hope you have lots of kids. I hope your first one's a boy that drools a lot like Johnny did and cries all the time. And every time you open that diaper, pees straight up in the air. Congratulations.
Peggy and David, we just want to just say how happy that you are today, and we want to wish you the best in your life. Marriage is a wonderful thing. We hope you enjoy it, and we wish you the best in happiness.
Peggy, thank you for honoring me by having me as a bridesmaid and a guest at your wedding. I wish you all the best.
Hey, Dave. Hey, Peggy. How you doing? It's been a long time. I'm glad you guys finally did it. It's a beautiful wedding. Ceremony was great. You guys did a great job. I'm really proud of you, and I hope you have many years of happiness together. Thank you.
Well, I just want to say congratulations, and hope it isn't long before you have one of these to play with, and said he has a friend to play with, and many years of health and happiness.
Dave, how's it feel to be here today?
He can't talk yet, and that's just as well, because, you know, we generally don't have nice things to say to each other, but Dave and Peggy, congratulations and good luck, and all that other fun stuff that's associated with that. Thanks.
I'm sticking in this time by walking down the aisle and messing up saying the prayer.
Jesus, and I close my eyes.
course, you know what that means? We're going to ask our groom to bring Mama home. Invite any parents who are here with their children, any fathers and daughters or mothers and sons, to come and join them on the dance floor. So any parents with their children here this evening, come on up and join them on the floor.
Honeymoon, and I'm glad you're together, and I hope you have a very, very happy wedding, I mean marriage, and I hope you live to have 50 years or better. Love, Aunt Kathy.
Thank you. David, congratulations. This is a day that I always looked forward to for over a year. I can't tell you how excited I am for you both. Just remember, I want you to be happy, and I want you both to make a life for yourselves and put the other side of the family second. I love you very much.
Hold on, we're gonna get, wait a second, no, don't wait until the music starts. First of all, we're going to give that back to Jimmy, so show us some leg there, Jimmy. All right. So here we go. Got some ink on his. Wait on a second, I forgot. For the women, it's the left leg. For the guys, it's the right leg. So we gotta put it up his right leg, okay? So show some skin there again, Jimmy, on the other leg. Ladies and gentlemen, they did a great job there. Now, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget our dessert table is still open over in the cocktail lounge, so if you still want to get some sweets to eat.
Congratulations, Peggy and Dave. Wish you all the luck in the world and the happiness in the world. We'll say congratulations.
Congratulations.
The back table know how to do it, so come up.
Congratulations, Dave and Peggy.
Yay!
Yay! Happy life.
Good life.
Hi, Peggy and David. I just want to wish you congratulations and all my love. And always remember, I'll be here for you if you need me. And I hope I get to hear some good news real soon in the future. You know what I'm looking forward to, kids. But if it doesn't work out, that's okay, too. We'll still have a good life. Love always, Mom.
Thank you.
Oh, Everybody, Peggy and I wanted to thank you all for coming to our wedding, and for those of you that couldn't make it, we hope you enjoyed watching the video. And I just like to end the note by saying to Peggy that I really enjoyed myself today. I'm honored that you're my wife, and I'm really looking forward to us growing old together. And enjoy the video, or I hope you enjoyed the video, and have a good night.